What time is it now, Manny?
Oh, before we get started, I would like to introduce you to our first annual drama class one-act play. Participants in this production include Will, playing the part of King Harold, Prince Engelbert, played by Jen. Jen is also playing the part of the page. The nanny, his old governess, played by Anya. Anya will also be playing the part of the fairy godfather. We hope that you enjoy this production, which is set in this castle, and it's titled My Son the Prince. Enjoy.
What time is it now, Nanny?
It's 1:30 Wednesday, Your Majesty.
Is that all? Seems later.
But Your Majesty, time wouldn't pass so slowly if you'd find something to occupy your mind. Why don't you take a nap or read a good book?
Well, that's easy enough for you to say, Nanny. What difference does it make you that my son is out making a fool of himself? You can sleep easily enough. Put yourself in my position for a minute. The embarrassment of all, humiliation, that son of mine is going to make me a laughing stock of the seven kingdoms.
Boys will be boys, Your Majesty.
Don't I know it? I have three sons. You'd think one of them would shape up and amount to something, but no. Three idiots, that's all I have. Three dunderheads.
Now, Your Majesty, they're not all as bad as that. They're boys.
Ha! King Percival. Now he's got what I call fine, upstanding sons. Regular princes, both of them.
I don't think those kids are anything special.
You don't, huh? The oldest, he wanted to get married. So what did he do? He found himself a girl who knew how to turn straw into yarn. That boy has brains.
But don't forget that he has to put up with that strange little man with the funny name living in the palace.
All right, so he has a little in-law trouble. With a wife who can turn straw into gold, you can learn to live with a little inconvenience. And the younger son, whom does he marry? Only the favorite daughter of the richest merchant of all seven kingdoms. And King Percival's younger son is no bargain, you know. Did you ever get a look at that kid's face? A regular beast, but marries a beauty. Those are sons. But in my three...
Now, what's so bad about your boys?
You've got to be kidding. My oldest, my pride and joy, is here to my kingdom. My Sheldon. Does he hunt? No. Does he fish? No. Does he go in archery or falconry or jousting like any normal red-blooded prince? No. He reads books. Who ever heard of a prince who reads books?
But that's how he mastered the art of black magic, from studying all those books of his. And if it weren't for his knowledge of magic, Your Majesty, he'd never have found his bride.
Some bride? A girl so lazy she once slept for 100 years. A girl with so little ambition he had to wake her up in order to propose.
But she was under a spell.
Well, indeed, that's just an excuse. She's lazy, I tell you. For a wedding present, I gave her one of those fancy household appliances, a spinning wheel. She took one look at it and fainted.
Surely, Your Majesty, you have no such complaint to make against your second son's bride.
She's a beauty girl, beautiful girl, true. But who needs those seven dwarfs of hers? Everywhere I go, it seems as if I'm falling over little men. Sometimes I wonder if this place is a palace. Or a YMCA. And another thing I don't like about her, she's a health food fattest or something.
Now, Your Majesty, surely you aren't being fair.
I mean it. The other day I said to her, take a piece of fruit, Snow White. Here's a nice apple. Does she say thank you like a civilized person? No, she screams, it's poison, it's poison. Believe me, if there were any poison around here, yours truly would be swallowing it. Do me a favor. Will you, and tell them to cut off that fanfare stuff. I've got a screamy headache as it is.
I think Prince Engelbert has come home, Your Majesty.
Well, it's about time.
I'm back, Father.
Hail the conquering hero.
Oh, don't make fun of me, Father. I've had a tiring day and I'm not in a good mood.
That's too bad, dear.
I gather then, you didn't find the girl you were looking for?
Uh-uh. But I'll look again tomorrow. I'll just keep looking and looking and looking.
And what if you never succeed? You can't spend the rest of your life going to the house of a dictionary salesman. You're a prince.
Sometimes I wish I weren't.
What? You watch your language in front of me, young man.
Well, I mean it, Father. Commoners don't have to go through all this trouble.
Commoners don't fall in love with glass slippers.
I'm not in love with the slipper. I'm in love with the girl who is in the slipper.
800 girls at a party, and he has to fall in love with the only party crasher. 800 names and addresses on the invitation list, and he picks the only one with an unlisted telephone number.
But she was so beautiful, Father, so delicate, so fragile.
And the others weren't? What about Rapunzel, for instance? Never in my life did I see such a beauty.
All the hair? Yeesh!
What about Odette? Neck like a swan.
Yeah, and feathers like a swan, and webbed feet like a swan.
All right, nobody's perfect.
Oh, Father, you don't know what love is. Real true love at first sight, love. Weren't you in love with Mother?
With your mother and me, it was different. I was a very ugly kid. Everyone called me Toad. Your mother took pity on me and kissed me one night. And suddenly, I felt like a prince. But you're handsome. You're smart. You're talented. You could have anyone you want. Why do you have to get hooked on a girl who's walking around right now with only one shoe? Can't you get them to stop those fanfares, Nanny?
I'll go and tell them, Your Majesty.
Engelbert, listen to your father. Think of all those things I've done for you. You wanted 7 league boots? I got you 7 league. You wanted to go away to college? I sent you to Fairyland Institute of Technology. You wanted to join a protest movement? I let you march up and down in front of the palace with a picket sign saying, "Royalty is unfair, monarchy must go." It wasn't easy, Engelbert, but I let you do what you wanted. Now I'm asking one little favor in return. Forget about the girl with size 3 feet and marry a regular princess, preferably the kind where they throw in half the kingdom and 500 green stamps into the bargain.
Money, money, money. Is that all your generation thinks about? Have you any ideals? What about love, art, humanity?
Fine words harvest no wheat, my boy.
What's that supposed to mean?
How should I know? I'm trying to be a responsible parent. That's how responsible parents talk.
Your Majesty, your fairy godfather is here to see you.
Wonderful, wonderful. You hear that, Engelbert? My fairy godfather is here. He'll put some sense into the head of yours. Don't just stand there. Show him in, show him in.
Yes, Your Majesty.
Leave it to him, Engelbert. Always there when you need him. That's what I call consideration.
His fairy godfather shit.
Good evening, Harold.
Good evening, fairy godfather. Boy, am I glad to see you.
Of course you are. You not only show up when you're in trouble. Well, Harold, what's the problem this time?
It's him.
Engelbert, what's wrong with him? He looks okay to me.
I'm not the problem. He is. I want to marry for love. He wants me to marry for money.
You have financial troubles, Harold?
No, it's nothing like that. It's just that the boy has some crazy idea about marrying a girl with glass slippers whose name he doesn't know, and I'm trying to talk a little sense into him.
What's so important about knowing the girl's name?
Look, whose side are you on?
It's not a question of sides, Harold. It's a question of communication. The boy's in love. Can't you understand that? Do you remember what it was like when you were his age? When you were concerned with love, art, humanity?
Look, it's not that I'm not sympathetic, but this is a dog-eat-dog world. It's time Angle were faced up to it and made a solid, responsible marriage.
Oh, Harold, I expected better than this from you. You were young yourself once.
Young and foolish. Just because I made mistakes, does he have to make them?
Mistakes? It sounds to me as if you've forgotten a certain young lady named Goose Girl.
No, I haven't forgotten.
Who was Goose Girl, Father?
It's a long story, Engelbert.
Goose Girl was the most beautiful girl in the whole Seven Kingdoms when your father was a lad, Engelbert. He fell in love with her and wanted to marry her.
Why didn't you marry her, Father?
Because his parents wanted him to make a sensible marriage. They picked out a girl for him, rich, yes, and even attractive, and a princess of the blood royal to boot. She'll make a man out of you, they said to him.
And she did. She turned me from a toad into a prince. Your mother was a wonderful woman, Engelbert. Don't you forget it.
But she wasn't the Goose Girl, was she, Harold?
No, she wasn't the Goose Girl.
What happened to the Goose Girl, Father? Did she die of a broken heart?
No, she married the prince from the next kingdom, Prince Charming. How I envied him. His parents were stuffy like mine. And the Goose Girl and Prince Charming had 7 beautiful children. Oh, they had their ups and downs, I guess. But in whole, I'd say they lived happily ever after.
And yet, after all these years, you haven't forgotten.
No, I haven't forgotten.
Well, Engelbert, I don't think you'll have any more problems with your father now. Go on with your search for the girl with the glass slipper. I'm sure that someday you'll find her.
You really think so?
I'm pretty sure of it. You'll find her and marry her, and though you'll have your little ups and downs, on the whole, you'll probably live happily ever after.
Oh, thank you. I'll resume my search at once.
You're a wonderfully wise fairy godfather. I appreciate your going out of your way for the kid like that.
Don't give it another thought, Harold.
Do you really think we'll ever find the girl with the glass slipper?
No doubt of it. But if I were you, just make sure. I'd track down a girl named Cinderella Watkins and see if she gets invited to dinner.
Is that the girl? Cinderella Watkins. Nice name. She doesn't live with any dwarfs, does she? And she doesn't take 100-year-long naps?
No, this one's a real jewel. She does have a thing about mice and pumpkins, but you'll get used to that. Well, I must be off.
But you just got here. Won't you stay for supper?
You think you're my only godchild? It isn't easy being a fairy godparent, let me tell you. Now that I've got your problem solved, I have to move on to somebody else.
Oh?
Yeah, and that named Midas. He keeps begging me to give him the golden touch, and this time I think I'm going to do it.
Yay! The end! Thank you so much! King, would you like to take a bow? And be part of both the governess and the fairy godfather. Will you, Anya, take a bow? And the part of both the page and Prince Engelbert, Jen. Excellent. Thank you for joining us for our play. We would love your reactions.